Hi everyone. If you're like me, memorizing all those trig identities was tedious and some of them are easy to forget. In this quick video, I'm going to show you a way to never have to remember those pesky trig identities again. Let's begin by drawing a hexagon, so we should have six specific points. Now, let's write the abbreviated versions of our trig functions, so we have tan for tangent, sine, and cosine, always moving clockwise. So what about the other three points? Well, across from each of the three trig functions, let's write the cotangent across from tangent, and cosecant across from sine. Lastly, we only have one trig function left, which is secant. Now let's draw a big number 1 in the middle, and that's it. If you can draw this hexagon, you can quickly recall all the trig identities without memorizing them. Let's understand how though. First, let's get our quotient identities. Let's first say we want to know the two tangent quotient identities. We start at tan, and we can move either clockwise or counterclockwise, both ways work, and take the first function we hit and set that as our numerator and the second one as our denominator. Therefore, we have our two quotient trig identities for tangent as sine over cosine and secant over cosecant. And if you were to look these up, they are indeed the quotient identities for tangent. I'm just going to quickly perform the rest of the quotient identities to confirm to you that this works. You may ask, well, what if I want, say, the reciprocal identities? Surely I can't get those from this hexagon. Well, we actually can very easily. We can get the reciprocal identities the same way as the quotient ones, except moving through the hexagon and not around it. So, if you want the reciprocal identity for tangent, we move through the hexagon and get 1 over cotangent, which is indeed the reciprocal identity for tangent. Again, I'm just going to quickly go through these and complete the rest to show you it works. We can also find the product identities using this hexagon. So, we select which function we want to find the product identity for, and select the two adjacent functions and multiply them together. So, if we want the product identity for tangent, we just multiply together secant and sine. As you can see here, this does indeed work for all the product identities as well. You can also use this hexagon to remember the Pythagorean identities. So, in these three purple triangles I have denoted here, if you were to move clockwise or counterclockwise, you will always have the Pythagorean identities. You just need to square each of these terms. An easy way to remember this is you're now making two turns, so square each term. As you can see here, all the Pythagorean identities were found correctly using this hexagon. Lastly, by moving only right on the hexagon, you can easily find the cofunction identities. So, starting at sine, we move to the right and multiply the function we hit by 90 degrees, or pi over 2 if you want radians, minus our input, which we typically use x for. This can also be done to find the cofunction identities for tangent and secant. Thank you for checking out this video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.